A very fine good morning to all. Hope you all are fit and fine. Today we are going to revise chapter number 2, addition and subtraction. In this chapter, firstly, we will do addition and its property, then subtraction and its property. Is it clear? Firstly, addition and its property, then subtraction and its properties. Have a look. Can anybody tell me what do you mean by addition? Hariya? Yes, what do you mean by addition? You have studied in grade 3rd also. What is the definition of addition? Very good. Addition means putting things together. Putting things together. Is it clear? You all are aware of the terms of addition. It is called sum and these two are called addends. Okay? Putting things together. And this is the terms of addition. Addends, sum. Now let's start. We have to add 1,25,820 and 3,02,158. Let's start. Firstly, write places. Then start writing first number, second number below the first number. Now simply you just have to add 0 plus 8, 8. We have studied already in the properties. Once again I am going to repeat the properties. 0 plus 8, whenever we are going to add 0 to any number, we get the number itself. 2 plus 5, 2 plus 5, 2. Keeping 2 in mind, start counting after 3. So after 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is it clear? Use the boxes of your fingers. 8 plus 1, it's very simple. 9. 5 plus 2, 7. 2 plus 0. Whenever 0 is added to any number, result is number itself. 1 plus 3, 4. Is it clear to everybody? Once again, I am repeating. When you have to add, firstly arrange the number according to their places. And then just arrange it column wise. Second number below first number. Now you have to perform addition. Is it clear? Keeping 2 in mind. Then start counting after 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like this. Okay? Is it clear? Sure. Coming to one more sum of addition. It's very easy. Yes, now see, solve this. Three numbers are given. Firstly, arrange these numbers according to places and in the column. Okay, see, first number here, second below first, third below second. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakhs. It's 3,651, 48,300. 9,36,850. Now you have to perform addition. 1 plus 0, 1 plus 0, 1. Whenever 0 is added to any number, result is number itself. 1 plus 0, 1. Now keep 1 in mind. These two results, the result of these two, will keep in mind. Then add 5. 1 plus 5. It's very simple. 6. Now 5 plus 0, 5. Then 5 plus 1, 6. You have already added these three numbers or numbers in your grade 3. You have already added. The only difference is that in the grade 4th, you are going to add 4 digits number. But in the grade 3rd, you have added numbers up to 3 digits. Okay. Here in the grade 4, you are going to add 5 digit numbers or 6 digit numbers also. Okay. Is it clear? So now 6 plus 3. Keeping 6 in mind, raise fingers 3. Or keeping 6 in mind, now count 3. 6 plus 3, 9. Is it clear? 6 plus 3. Keeping 6 in mind, start counting after 6. 7, 8, 9. 7, 8, 9. Is it clear? Sure. Keeping 6 in mind, 7, 8, 9. Now keeping 9 in mind, count 8. Start counting after 9. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay. Now 3 plus 8, 11. 11 plus 6, 17 plus 1, 18. Okay. 4 plus 3, very good. 7 plus 1, 8. And here 9 as it is. Is it clear? Sure? Very good. So, in this way you have to complete this addition. Now let's start with properties of addition. Now see the properties of addition. First property says, when we are going to add number in any order, the numbers are 25,817, 12,352. When we add number in any order, the result remain same. Okay? First here number is 25,817. There second number is this. Here second number is 12,352. And this number comes first. Comes on first position in that side. So it means they are equal. If we are going to add in any order, the result remain same. Is it clear? Now see, second property, if we add 1 to the number, we get its successor. We get its successor. Okay? Property number 3rd. If we add 0, we get the number itself. If we add 0 to the number, we get number itself. Property number 4. If we are going to add, what we are going to add? Can anybody tell me? Yes. If we are going to add the 3 numbers in any order, the result remains same. See, these 3 numbers, firstly I add these, then this. In that, I add these, then at last 12,000. So the result remains same. Is it clear? 3 numbers added in any order give the same answer. Adding 0 to the number give the number itself. Adding 1 to the number give the successor of that number. And here this is a 2 number, when added in any order give the same answer. Okay, very good. Now let's start with subtraction. Yes, now come to subtraction. You all know that taking away a number from the greater number. Taking away a number from the greater number is called subtraction. Okay? Subtraction has 3 terms. Let's see. The number which is subtracted is called subtrahend. okay, and the number from which we subtract is called minuend, and the result is difference. Is it clear? The number which is subtracted, subtrahend. The number from which we subtract, minuend, and the result is difference. Okay. Now see, subtract 54,361 from 78,579. Is it clear? So, how we are going to solve? Here, bigger number, greater number come first, then we will write smaller number. Because the definition of subtraction says taking away a smaller number from the greater. Okay? Now start subtraction. 9 minus 1, 8. 7 minus 6, 1. 5 minus 3, 2. 8 minus 4, 4. 7 minus 5, 2. Is it clear? You have to just subtract the digits. Okay? Taking away a smaller from the greater, and the result is called difference. Is it clear? Sure? Very good. Now let's perform one more sum. Yes. Now see this subtraction. 0 minus 7. It is not possible. So it will take borrow from this. Here it become 4. And now it become 10. 10 minus 7, 3. Now subtract 9 from 4. It is not possible. So it will take borrow and become 14. And here left 2. 14 minus 9. Very good. It's 5. Okay. Now 2 minus 4. It is not possible. So it will take 1 from here. And here it become 1. 12 minus 4. It's 8. 1. And here minus 6. It is not possible. So it will take 1 borrow and become 11 minus 6. That is 5. And here 8 minus 2, 6. And simply, can anybody tell me what's come next? Hurry up. Yes. Very good. Is it clear? Sure. It will take borrow and the digit here get reduced. Then again it will take borrow and again it will take borrow. Is it clear? Sure. So here the answer is 6,65,853. Is it clear? Very good. Is it clear? So in this way you can perform subtraction. Now let's do the properties of subtraction. It's very easy. Properties of subtraction. Okay, let's start with properties of subtraction. Now see, it's very easy. When we are going to subtract 0 from the number, we get number itself. We get number itself. Is it clear? And property number 2, when we are going to subtract number from itself, we get result 0. Okay? And the property number 3, when we subtract 1 from the number, we get predecessor of that number. Okay? Sure it is clear? So please, let's revise again. When we subtract 0 from the number, we get number itself. When we subtract number from itself, we get 0. When we subtract 1, we get predecessor of that number. Okay? So with these, we have completed addition and subtraction and their properties. Now, try this sum. If you face any problem, we are going to discuss your problem in our Zoom class. With this, thank you very much. Have a nice day.